Christian Schaffalitzky of Eurasia Mining is with me. Christian, good to see you. Thanks very much for popping in.
My pleasure.
Plenty happening with you at the moment. First off, where Monchetundra is concerned, you've lodged your application today. Bring us up to speed on developments there.
Yes, well, we got approved by the Russian government our 1.9 million ounce reserves and resources in the Monchetundra project for two open pits to be developed in the future. And that approval of reserves is the key step in going towards a mining license. And the next step in the Russian procedure means once you have your reserves registered, within 30 days you must lodge an application for a discovery certificate, which allocates the rights of those reserves to you. Mm-hmm. And we lodged that this week.
Launched that this week. When do you reckon you might hear back on that?
Typically, it takes 30 to 40 days. That's been our experience before. Mm-hmm. with our West Kytlim project. So we assume it's a similar timescale.
So it's a wait and see on that. What about as far as mine construction plans?
Obviously, there are a few. You have to get a lot of things in order before you open a mine. And the permits is one thing, getting the licenses, getting that sorted out with the government, get their approvals. Then in parallel, last year we agreed a turnkey EPC contract with Sinosteel for $175 million development of the project. And this package from Sinosteel provides 85% of the financing we will need to build the mine and the plant. And now, basically, the next 12 months will be spent waiting for a mining license in due course. Again, it's the Russian timescale, not mine. But, you know, that's been our experience again. You know, it's a fairly systematic process, which is well understood. So with a bit of luck, we have a few of the problems sorted.
Absolutely. So that's where Monchetundra is concerned. But that's quite... it's worth taking a step back for a moment, because before we talk about Semenovsky and West Kytlim, that really re-emphasizes the business structure, really, because Monchetundra is the big focus for you, and
indeed,
these other two arms of the business helps bring in a bit of cash, keeps things ticking along.
That's exactly right. Monchetundra is what we hope will be our company maker. That's what we aim it to be. And in parallel, because the market has been so weak for our sector for many years now, we had to look at alternative ways of raising finance to run our business. And having a small mine at West Kytlim is a big contributor to that model. And happily, we are this year launching our first full year of production. Last year, we started in September, was a third of the season. Right. Alluvial mining is seasonal. Mm-hmm. And you know, you can only work when the water isn't frozen, because we're washing the sands to produce the platinum concentrate.
And what are your targets at West Kytlim?
We're targeting this year 100 kilos of production. And we are hopeful that will be met. Partly it's seasonal, of course. Is the season going to be short or long? Mm-hmm. But so far, we're still hopeful that we'll meet the target.
Very good. Where Semenovsky is concerned, you've been given until the end of August, is it, to make up your mind with as to regard to what you're going to do there?
Yes, the owner and myself were obviously in constant communication, because I'm now doing my best to raise the capital to develop the mine, and we're basically going to be processing tailings from previous gold mining operations. But the grade of these tailings is really very high; it's over a gram, and tailings are viable there are even ones in South Africa running at 0.3 grams per ton. So it's a very good grade, but of course it's all about the recovery, and our test work so far suggests that we'll recover about 40% of the gold that's in that tailings. And happily, that's viable economically. So we're now working with two potential design teams to help us with designing and building the plant. And regarding the financing, all I can say at the moment is that we're talking again to various people about that. But again, I'm not interested in raising equity mm-hmm. for that particular job. We'll find a way, like we did at West Kytlim, where we basically shared the risk with the mining contractor.
Are you quite pleased overall with how things are coming along?
Yeah, I mean, it would be nice. As shareholders will know, we have a bit of debt still sitting on the balance sheet at the moment, and I'd like to get rid of that. Mm. But then we would be in very good shape once that's done.
So the next 6 to 12 months, then, sort of all eyes on Monchetundra, waiting for that license to come through, and then full steam ahead.
Yeah, continuing mining at West Kytlim, of course, and then hopefully developing Semenovsky in the very near future.
Very good to see you, Christian. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you very much.